Welcome to a new video. This tutorial will show you how to repair the instrument cluster of Volkswagen Golf and Bora using Minitools replacement LCD. For this repair, you will need the following tools. Position the dashboard as shown, and with the Torx screwdriver, undo the two side screws. With the head of the spudger, pry on the plastic clips to remove the front cover. Undo the rear one as well. Fit the gauge faces protective discs and remove the needles, gently rotating and pulling them. Act on the clips of the metal frames of the two sides screens. Undo all clips of the front plastic of the panel and of the reset button and release the board. Undo and remove the frame of the display as well. With some Kapton tape, thermally insulate the components close to the FPC, which has to be desoldered with a hot air desoldering iron. Remove the tape, then any tint residues with the solder wick and clean with some solvent. With the aid of some Kapton tape, place the small PCB supplied with the Minitools display matching the contacts on the board, leaving 1 mm gap as shown. With the soldering iron with conical tip at 350 degrees, solder the small PCB on some points to fix it on the board. Then, solder each pin individually. Clean with some solvent. Remove the Kapton tape. Insert the FPC of the Minitools display into its connector on the small PCB. Close the connector. Peel off the rear protective film and position the display on its housing. Carefully fold the FPC. Taking the shown references, cut off the left part of the frame with electronic shears. Slightly file the bottom corners of the clips so to avoid damages to the LCD glass. Peel off the front film, fit and secure the frame. Carefully follow the following instructions before reassembling the dashboard. Switch on the dashboard. If the information is displayed clearly and sharply on the screen, the problem is solved. If the screen would light up but not show any info, with a multimeter check the voltage between the points indicated in the figure, which should be between 11.50 volts and 12.50 volts. If it's not in that range, it's necessary to double-check the soldering made on the small PCB. If the instrument cluster is produced by VDO and has an EEPROM 93C66 on the rear part of the board, the voltage has to be measured between the points B and GND shown in the picture as well. In this case, the value of the voltage between the points B and GND has to be at least 4.50 volts. If it's lower, it's necessary to solder a jumper between the point B on the small PCB and the pin 8 of the EEPROM 93C66. Making sure not to damage the two side screens, put back the base with the gauge's faces, attaching it to the board and carefully secure the frames of the side screens. Put back the needles and with the Minitools shim, push them at the right level. Then bring them back to their original position. Reattach the rear cover, then the front one. Tighten the screws. Switch on the dashboard. Perfetto! Problem solved! Thank you for choosing Minitools.